The SI unit of force is Newton. In our daily life, we apply forces for doing different types of activities. For example, if we want to lift a glass of water, then we have to apply force. Without applying force, we can't lift that glass of water. During riding a bicycle, we have to apply force on the pedal of the bicycle. Then bicycle change its position. If we want to go inside a car, then we have to apply force to the car door to get in. Like that, in our daily life, to perform various activities, we apply forces. Now, come to the point that how can we describe the force? How can we describe the force? Force can be described by stating its magnitude as well as direction. Force can be described by stating its magnitude and direction. Magnitude, here the word magnitude means value. So see here, force can be described by stating its magnitude and direction. Mind it, here direction is very important for the term force. Force को हम लोग कैसे describe कर सकते हैं? We can describe force by stating its magnitude and direction. Magnitude और direction बता करके force को हम describe करते हैं. It means force एक ऐसा quantity है जिसके पास magnitude भी होता है और direction भी होता है. That's why we term force as a vector quantity. Here again new term come, vector quantity. Quantity which has both magnitude as well as direction, that quantity is referred as vector quantity or called as vector quantity. So force is also a vector quantity. Why it is a vector quantity? Because it has both magnitude and direction. Since force has both magnitude and direction, therefore it is a vector quantity. Force a vector quantity, or vector quantity ko hum log represent karte hain by applying one arrow sign over its abbreviation. Jaise force ko hum log represent karte hain F से, फोर्स को रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं F से, और उस F के ऊपर में अगर हम लोग एक एरो साइन अगर रिप्रेजेंट करेंगे, then this represent that force is a vector quantity. Why force is a vector quantity? Because it has both magnitudes and directions. Now, for example, see here. For example, a force of a force of 10 Newton acting downward. What does it mean? A force of 10 Newton acting downward. Here, this 10 Newton represents magnitude and this downward represents direction along which the force acts. Force of 10 Newton acting downward, in this sentence, this 10 Newton represents magnitude and then downward represents the direction of the force. Now come to the formula of force. What is the formula of force? If it is a physical quantity to and we can measure it, then there must be some formula. The formula of force is given by F is equals to mx, and this formula is given by a famous scientist named Newton by the second law of Newton, which you will read in your next class, in your ninth class. So the formula of force is given by F equals to ma. Now see here, at F we can apply the arrow sign. Why? Because force is a vector quantity, and again upon acceleration we will apply arrow sign, because acceleration is again a vector quantity. But this mass is not a vector quantity, mass is a scalar quantity. It has only magnitude, it has not direction. Iske paas koi direction nahi hoti, it has only magnitude. That's why we will not apply here arrow sign. The formula for force is F is equals to ma. We have already read that the SI unit for force is Newton. Now from this formula we can derive the SI unit. See, how can we do this? See, what is the SI unit of mass? What is the SI unit for mass? The SI unit for mass is kg. You all know that. Now what is the SI unit for acceleration? We have already read before. The SI unit for acceleration is meter per second square. So overall, what is the SI unit of force come here? The SI unit of force come here is kg meter per second square. But instead of saying this kg meter per second square, we term it as Newton, in the honor of the name of scientist Newton. उनके सम्मान में इतना नहीं बोल करके, kg meter per second square नहीं बोल करके हम लोग क्या बोलते हैं? Newton बोलते हैं. For example, we say 5 Newton force acting towards is direction. 5 Newton force. We don't say that 5 kg meter per second square force is acting towards is direction. We say that 5 Newton, 10 Newton, 50 Newton. Is this clear? Now let us start next topic, that is resultant or net force. Our next topic is resultant force. We also call it as or net force. What is this resultant force? What do we mean by this term, resultant force? Resultant force is a single force which is equal to the sum of all the forces acting on a body. एक ऐसा सिंगल फोर्स है जो किसके बराबर है, बाकी जितने भी फोर्सेस बॉडी पे एक्ट कर रहे हैं उन सब की जगह पे एक फोर्स की जैसे ये एक्ट करता है. सो वी कैन से दैट हियर रिजल्टेंट फोर्स इज डिफाइंड एज a single force which is obtained by combining a set of forces acting on a body. Once again, resultant force is defined as single force. एक वैसा single force which is obtained, जो कैसे हमें मिलेगा? By combining a set of forces. Set of forces means जितने भी सारे forces act करें, सबको combine करने से, जितने सारे forces body में act करें, उन सबको कंबाइन करने से जो एक सिंगल फोर्स मिलेगा, दैट सिंगल फोर्स इज डिफाइंड एज और टर्म एज रिजल्टेंट फोर्स. और देन अनदर डेफिनेशन ऑफ रिजल्टेंट फोर्स इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ एक्सेलरेशन. सो रिजल्टेंट फोर्स इज डिफाइंड एज सिंगल फोर्स विच प्रोड्यूस द सेम एक्सेलरेशन एज प्रोड्यूस बाय सेट ऑफ फोर्सेस. और यू कैन से दैट रिजल्टेंट फोर्स is defined as a single force which produces the same acceleration as produced by a set of forces acting on a body. वो सिंगल फोर्स जो उतना ही एक्सेलेरेशन प्रोड्यूस करता है जितना कि बाकी सारी फोर्सेस मिलकर के एक्सेलेरेशन प्रोड्यूस करते हैं. दैट फोर्स इज ऑल्सो नोन एज, दैट सिंगल फोर्स इज नोन एज रिजल्टेंट फोर्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल सी हियर, suppose let us understand this the resultant force with the help of cases. That will be very easy. अब इस रिजल्टेंट फोर्स को केसेस से समझते हैं. सपोज ए बॉडी इज लाइंग ऑन ए हॉरिजॉन्टल सरफेस. दिस इज बॉडी एंड दिस बॉडी इज लाइंग, ये बॉडी है, एक बॉडी हॉरिजॉन्टल सरफेस पे लाइंग है. नाउ this is your case one. Suppose two forces of different magnitude or same magnitude are acting along the same direction. What I said, if two forces of different magnitude are acting along the same direction, then what will be its resultant force? Suppose there is one force acting F1 and another force F2. These two forces are acting in the same direction, the direction is towards right, then what will be the resultant force? What will be the that single force of these two forces? We have already learned that resultant force is the single force for the set of forces. So see here, if two forces are acting along the same direction, then its resultant force, then its resultant force, or we can write it as FR. We can write it as F. This FR represents resultant force, is equal to the sum of these two forces, F1 plus F2. F1 plus F2. यहाँ हमने arrow sign क्यों दिया? Because we all know that force is a vector quantity. So this resultant force is the sum of two forces. When it will be the sum of two forces? If the two forces will act in the same direction. This is your case one. And the direction is towards right direction. Now case two. If